Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the BF Photographer channel, and in this video we're going to be going over the powerful layer masks tool in Capture One Pro 20, which allows you to specifically adjust certain areas of a photo so you can apply adjustments like exposure, white balance, levels, and curves to particular areas in your image. Let me show you exactly what layer masks do. And to do that, I'm going to disable each layer here in this image, and we're going to walk through it from the beginning. So I started with this image right here, straight out of the camera, and did some basic background adjustments using the exposure and high dynamic range tab. Then I brightened Julia's eyes with a layer here. I brightened her dress with its own layer. Then I reduced the highlights on her face. And then I adjusted the colors in the background. In any of these layers, you can see the area in red, and that is the selected or masked area. For instance, here I have the background selected. Here I have her face. Here I have her dress, etc. So, the layer with the background mask. You guessed it, if I slide exposure to the left, it's going to make only the background darker, because that's the area that I selected using the brush tool. If I were to go to the right and make the exposure brighter, it's again only going to affect the background area and not going to affect Julia's skin, her dress, her face, her hands, none of that at all. So I can control the colors and the curves in the background. For instance, if I wanted to add an S-curve, we can drag the curves down here in the shadows. Bring up the highlights, and now you can see with just that one layer, we've made the background really pop and added some color to it very quickly. So let me show you how to actually create a layer mask. Let's reset this image here, and I'll simply do a couple of background adjustments. Let's say, for instance, we want to make Julia's eyes pop. What we're going to do is zoom in, hit the plus icon here on the left, and rename this layer from layer 1 to eyes. Hit enter. And it's renamed. Now what you do is you either hit the B key for brush on your keyboard or hit this little draw mask brush icon here, and now you have a brush selected. Two things you need to do before doing that. One, press the M key on your keyboard so that way when you draw a mask it shows you in red where that mask is, and two, right click and select the size of your mask. So you can see as we go from the left that's smaller, and we go to the right that gets larger. So I want a really small size here to brush on her eyes. So here you can see we are now brushing on her eyes. And if you're not seeing the brushing happen in red, that means you have to press the M key for mask on your keyboard. So you could be brushing in a lot of places and not even know it, and you have to press M to see where that is. If you brushed in the wrong area, simply hit the E key or this eraser icon here. And again, you can change the size of the eraser by right clicking and doing your eraser settings. And we can change the area that we drew on or erased just by doing that. So here we have a mask that's selected on the eyes, and now we can adjust exactly that area. So if we grab the exposure, drag to the right, it's gonna make our eyes brighter. If we want them darker, we can just drag to the left. So I'm gonna make this just a little bit brighter. We'll go down to clarity and add a little bit of clarity here. And now you can see just with that one layer, here's the eyes before, let me press M. And here's the eyes after. So you can see we made the eyes pop by simply adding a layer mask. Now let me show you a handy trick if you want to select a very particular subject that doesn't have a lot of contrast. Let's select Julia's dress. Now the eyes were really easy because they're small and a brush can just mask the whole eye, but if we create a new layer and call this one dress, we can see that it's not going to be the easiest thing. I mean, even if we did a large brush, it's kind of hard to get it specific. And we're going to have a difficult time, you know, dealing with the hair and this gap in the arms and all that. So what we can do is simply make an outline on the edge of her dress and then make it fill. Now, it might be a little bit hard to detect the edges here. Of course, we can zoom in, but it's still not that easy. So my trick for you is go to the background layer, bring the brightness up way too high, make it just look absolutely horrible. And then you're going to go back on the dress layer. And we're simply going to click and drag on the outside edges of the dress. Now you can see that we have most of the dress covered, and there's a big gap in this area here and on the right side. Well, the great thing is you can right click on the layer mask, hit fill mask, and there you go, this entire area selected. Again, if we want to erase this area of the background between her arm and the dress, we just hit the E key, make our brush size a little bit smaller, and we can simply erase the mask from here. A quick shortcut for you, if you tap the left bracket key, that's the one on your keyboard right next to the P key, you can make the brush smaller. And if you want to make the brush bigger, you can tap the right bracket key and that'll make it bigger. Now we don't need to get into these fine details here. So if we zoom out, we now have control of just the dress. So if I press M to turn off the layer mask, we can turn down our background again. So let's go to our background layer here. And now if we go on to the dress settings, we can control the contrast of the dress. So I can make it much darker, or if I want to, I could add less contrast to the dress. And now I have full control over the dress. If we want to make it brighter just in the shadows, again, we can bring it up with the curves or make it darker and add a simple S curve here, bring up the midpoints. And the nice part is you can change how strong that layer mask effect is. So we can drop the opacity to 0 and slide to the right to make it stronger. So now you can see we simply adjusted the dress with a layer mask, and that curve and the exposure contrast adjustment is done only on the dress. What if you wanted a layer mask to affect the entire image or most of the image, and then you can just erase from it? Well, in that case, you can do a layer mask for the entire image like I did here for the color grade. And what's great is this then gives you the ability to control the opacity of your adjustments like a color grade by having the entire layer done. So to do this, instead of tapping on the plus icon, all you're going to do is hold on it and you will see new filled layer. So now any adjustments we make on that filled layer are done on the entire image. You can see if I press M on the keyboard, the entire area is selected. So let's say we just want to do a quick exposure change and color grade. We could do it on this layer. Let's say we're just going to add a little bit of green in the midtones. There we go. And that's way too intense. But I do like that style, I just don't want it to be as strong. I can simply slide the opacity down, and now you can see when we turn that layer on and off, we have the entire image controlled. Let's say for whatever reason, we didn't want that to affect the Apple logo. We want this to kind of stay pure black and not be affected by the grade that we have on that layer. So all I'm gonna do is hit M for mask, hit E for erase, and then I'm gonna turn on auto mask here, change my size to be a little bit smaller, and now you can see we can simply go through and select, if we bring our flow up to 100, we can simply select the Apple logo area and it's doing a pretty good job. There we go. So now we have our image with the color grade done on everything except for the Apple logo. And that was super quick and easy just by doing create new fill layer. And next time I'm going to show you how to do radial masks and gradient masks, so that way you can do perfect circles and adjust your skies and make them look beautiful. Hope you subscribe. Thanks for watching. Peace.